Good evening, people. Watch Romans 65, Lisa Boyce. I'm going to give you the gospel. It's in 1 Corinthians 15, 1 through 4. Christ shed his blood for all of our sins, past, present, and future. Was buried and rose again on the third day according to scripture. We're saved by grace through faith in Christ alone. Not of ourselves, not of works, lest any man should boast. It is grace, something we didn't earn, something we don't deserve, that God gave his only begotten son, that whosoever, you and I, or whosoever, believe in him will not perish but have eternal life. Now, how do you come to the knowledge of believing? How do you come to believing? You admit you're a sinner in need of Christ. The moment you put your faith and trust in Christ Jesus, not man, not yourself. It's only through the blood of Jesus. Robert Breaker talks about it all the time. It's only through the blood of Jesus that we're justified. The moment you put your faith and trust in Christ Jesus, the moment you accept Christ as Savior, not only are you saved, but you are justified by the blood of Jesus. Rapture ready and sealed until the day of redemption. Rapture is going to happen at any time. Only way you can be left behind is if you're not saved. Otherwise, the saved, sealed, are going to be caught up in the rapture. And you are sealed until the day of redemption, which means you cannot and will not lose your salvation. The Holy Spirit will indwell in you. The Holy Spirit will lead you, guide you. The Holy Spirit is your best friend. And the Holy Spirit will change you. Tonight, something was supposed to happen. Now, I did a video on this. I think it was either yesterday or Friday. And there's a lot happening behind the scenes. And this was off Hal Turner. And a friend of mine did some research and found out that, today is the day. Now, if you remember, I reported and I did a video on the people on these top ranking officials going to what's called the hotel. Remember that? And in this video, he revealed that senior aide to the sitting U.S. Senator for 25 years was told earlier this last week, just pack up their bags and leave for the hotel today. Today. The phrase, the hotel, is government speak for nuclear bunkers. Yeah, I did a video on it just the other day. Now, anyone near Greenbrier in West Virginia, this is a hotel where the U.S. built underground nuclear bunkers for the U.S. Congress back in the 1950s, but it is allegedly decommissioned now. Any significant helicopter traffic there? Yeah. Now, this is the latest, and this just came out today. Remember Senator Fetterman from PA, who was admitted to the hospital for depression? Well, he's out of the public eye. But his wife and kids left for Canada. Remember Senator Feinstein? Allegedly admitted in the hospital for shingles. There's no hospital stay for shingles. She's out of the public eye. Our governor here in Ohio, DeWine, supposedly broke his leg at East Palestine. He's out of the public eye. And by the way, I haven't heard anything about it. Nuisance. California Governor Newsom left on personal travel. Guess where he's going? Hasn't been seen or heard from. Guess where he's going? Can't verify it for sure, but he was at a Denver airport. What's in Denver? Yeah. A continuity of government facility underground here, but you know. It said, he goes on to say here, I was also told last night that other governors are being sent to various facilities and they are not being told where they are. Something's going to happen this week. I can feel it. And I just don't know what. I'm praying it's the rapture. I'm really praying it's the rapture. But something is going to happen this week. Now, this came out on RT, and this just came out. I just looked this up. I guess this came out at tomorrow's time, but yet it's for it just came out today because they're, of course, is Russian and they're ahead. Netanyahu is justifying strikes on nuclear facilities. So, Prime Minister Netanyahu has insisted that the option of attacking and I did a video on this slightly yesterday, I believe, or Friday. Netanyahu has insisted that the option of attacking a nuclear facility in self-defense must be left on the table, arguing that the chief of the United Nations International Atomic Energy Agency made an unworthy statement when he declared that any such strikes are banned. Now listen to this, because this came out at the same time. Today, this came out. Iran makes a pledge to the United Nations nuclear watchdog. Iran has assured the International Atomic Energy Agency that it will restore the UN's watchdog's access to some of the monitoring tools at its nuclear facilities. The IAEA Director General Rafael Mariano Grossi has revealed. Over the past few months, there was a reduction in some of the monitoring activities, including cameras and other equipment, which were not operating. But the nuclear watchdog and Iran have agreed that those will be operating again. So what is Iran and the nuclear watchdog? The United Nations nuclear watchdog, are they friends now or what? What's going on? And we go back to Netanyahu, who says Netanyahu rant came a day after the IAEA director Rafael Grossi was asked by a reporter about U.S. and Israeli threats to attack Iran if it doesn't agree to curb its nuclear program. You see how they're all in cahoots? Israel is going to end up defending herself. Any military attack on a nuclear facility is outlawed. It's out of the normative structures that we all abide by, Grossi said at a press briefing in Iran after meeting with Iranian leaders. The principle applies to all nuclear facilities, including Europe's biggest atomic facility in Zaporozhye. Netanyahu said no such prohibition could apply to Israel. Rafael Grossi is a worthy person who made an unworthy remark, he said. Outlawed by what law? Is Iran, which publicly calls for the extermination allowed to protect its weapons of destruction that will slaughter Israel. this is getting heated. Actually, it's at a boiling point because Netanyahu is going to go off at any day now. Really. Grassi's trip to Iran apparently paid dividends as Iranian officials agreed to restore the United Nations watchdog's access to some surveillance tools at the country's nuclear facilities. The IAEA also was granted an increase in inspections at the Fordo nuclear site, as well as additional verification and monitoring activities. Somebody's in somebody's back pocket. Seems like it. I will link these articles in the description box. It's going to be an interesting week, to say the least. We shall see what happens. I'll link both this one and the one from Al Turner in the description box. If anything else comes up, I'll be back. Again, it's going to be an interesting week. God bless. Thank you.